Hello friends, welcome back. We are continuing with our different views in MVC, and in this session we are going to focus on layout view. So let us see what is a layout view. Before that, let us revise the types of views in MVC. The first one is standard view, second one is strongly typed view, third one is layout view, and fourth one is partial view. We already completed with a standard view and strongly typed view. Those who do not know what is standard view and strongly typed view, please watch my that videos. And today our focus is on layout view. Okay, so what is a layout view, right? Whenever we develop any website or web application, our multiple web pages share some common design or common UI part. So instead of writing that design part or design code again and again, or copying it and pasting it, it is better to place it somewhere in a common place, right? That will be definitely a feasible solution. So layout view is the place where you can keep your common design part, a common UI part. Suppose, assume that if we have a common header, okay, where we are displaying our menus, logo of website, etc. Okay, there is a left menu, there is a right sidebar. In footer section, there is some common part like links to your terms and conditions, privacy policies, etc. Okay, so that part is common. So instead of placing it in each and every place, it is better to place it in a layout view. And your content particular to your page will change dynamically, right? Those who are familiar with ASP.NET web form can compare it with a master page. Now let us see some facts about layout view. So as I told you, it contains common UI parts, so you do not write the same code again and again. Now the second thing, what it does, how it is advantages, it eliminates the duplicate coding, it enhances the development speed, and maintenance of a code is also easy. Now the extension of a layout view is also same as of a normal view, that is either CSHTML or VBHTML depending on the language you have chosen. And since the extension is same like of our normal view, you can convert any view to layout view. Now layout views are always placed in a shared folder, because according to the MVC concept, whatever common to your multiple views is kept in a share folder, which is located under the views folder. We are going to see this practically also. Now our view has one property, that is layout property, and to the layout property you have to assign the path of your layout page. Okay, say you have 10 views and each view is having a layout view. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to assign layout property with a path of our layout page. So instead of defining that path again and again, what is done in MVC, there is one view start view or view start CSHTML file where path of our layout page is specified, and it is automatically applicable to all the views in our application. Okay, so view start, you can say it is a common place where you can assign a path of layout. Now suppose for 1 to 2 views you want to alter the layout property, because if there is a view start file, definitely it is going to be executed and layout property get assigned, or layout property get initialized. But suppose for some reason or for uniqueness of a particular page you want to change the layout property, you definitely override this property in individual view also. We are going to see this part practically. Okay, now whenever we say that layout view contains the common things, now where that specific thing occurs, right, where the specific things of particular view occurs and how to display the specific things related to that particular view. So for that, layout view uses render body method. Layout view uses render body method. So wherever you want the content of a specific page to be appeared, you have to call the render body method in your layout view, and it is used only once in a layout view. Remember this thing, and definitely it is logical. You cannot say render view again and again. You want to render your content only once. Okay, so render body function should be called only once. Now what render body function does? It renders all the content of view which is not wrapped in name section. What is section? We are going to see this part, but time being, remember that the contents which are not wrapped in sections, all the contents get rendered where render body method is called. So let us say this concept practically. Now here I have already created one application layout view. I already added one controller, home controller, and there is already one index method. Okay, so let us add a view. See, if you want to create a layout view, you can create it manually also. Just right click over here, add the shared folder using new folder, and under that shared folder add the layout page. So actually I am going to use a technique of scaffolding. Okay, at initial level definitely it will be easy for us, then after, once you get familiar with this, you can manually create your folder. So my suggestion will be to follow the scaffolding technique, and once you get proficient in that particular part, you can follow this process manually also. So instead of creating shared folder manually and layout view manually, I'm going to use a scaffolding technique. So let us add a view for this. Say add view. Now to create a layout page automatically, you have to mark this checkbox, okay, and say add MVC will create a layout view for us. Now please observe your solution explorer. Okay, now as you can see, some content folder get added, script folder get added, okay, and the shared folder get added, layout view is also added. So let us add some text here. Say welcome to Code Semantic. Okay. Now I am executing this. See, as you can see here, welcome to Code Semantic part is available. Okay, it get rendered, but you may wonder that this part 2018 copyright 2018, then my ASP.NET application here, the application name, we didn't added this part. Then how it appears? If you look at the page source, you will also observe that there is a HTML tag, there is a head tag, there is a body tag. Okay, we only specified this much part. Then how this part appears? Okay, and the answer is layout view. Okay, so index view has a layout, because while creating a view index view, we take the option of layout page. So automatically the index view get assigned this layout page. Now let us have a look on layout page. See, look at here carefully. There is HTML tag, head tag, body tag. Okay, this footer section where copyright part is wrote. Okay, everything is there in our layout view. And time being, please ignore this @html.action link. We are going to see this part later in our helper topic. Okay. The most important thing that you have to observe here is the call to render body method, right? Okay, so here in this area or at this place, the content of our index view, that is this h2 tag, get render. Okay, so wherever you give call to render body method, the content of your view get render. Now For time being, I'll just make some change here so it will be more readable to us or more understandable. Contents starts here. Okay. And after completing this render body method, I'll say contents ends here. Okay. So let us refresh our page. Okay. So it is showing you, right? Means I want to show that where render body is called, your content of the views get rendered there. Now how it get assigned, right? Okay, I already told you that there is a view start file, and in view start file the layout property of our page get initialized, where the path of layout page is assigned to our layout property of a view. Okay, so let us debug this so it will be more clear to you. So my application is already running. I'm switching to browser. I'm refreshing this. Okay, now I'm pressing F11. See, when you say return view, first time it goes to viewstart.cshtml file. If I place my mouse pointer here, initially my layout is null. Once it get initialized, okay, now my layout is get assigned with this layout.cshtml page. Now it is executing this. Now it is switching to the layout page. Now layout part is executing. Now render body method is called. At that place our content of index view get rendered. And whatever C# code is there, it also get executed. Okay. So every time when view is returned, first of all view start file get executed. Now, as I told you that we can override this layout property. Okay, definitely we can override this layout property. Okay, how? See, first of all, this viewstart.cshtml part get executed, then our view get executed, where you can alter the layout property of a view. Now, for that, I will create one layout page first. Okay, so let me add that page, add view. In this way also you can add a view. Now since it is itself a layout view, I am not going to take this option. Okay, let me name my layout view as my layout. Now one more convention in MVC is that the view which are incomplete always starts with an underscore. Okay, see, layout is incomplete view. It has just a common content. Similarly, partial views are also incomplete view. We are going to see this that part in the next section. But the views which are incomplete, the naming convention for that view is that it always starts with an underscore. It is just a convention. It is not a rule, so you may ignore it, but it is good practice to follow the convention. Okay. So let us say add. Now here. Now if you observe here, since it is not, it is a layout view, okay, not a normal view. So HTML, head tag, everything get added. So let me define some nice heading, say my layout. Okay, here to my div tag, I'll assign a background color style, say BG color, sorry, background color. Say this allies blue. Okay, now what I want to do, I want to assign this layout view to my index view. So for that I have to use layout property. Now specify the path. Now what is our path? See, up to views we have to give path to our root. So that is specified by tilde sign and slash, then views, then after shared folder, and inside the shared folder, my layout.cshtml. Okay, so thus we override the layout property. Okay, now I already placed a big debug point here. Let us execute. So first of all, it will go to view start file, okay, where the layout property get initialized. Okay, now here layout property get altered. See, now it is underscore layout.cshtml where it is set in view start file. Now once this part get executed, layout property will initialize with my layout.cshtml. okay, what we missed? We missed a render body function, right? That's why it is giving me an error. So let us make that correction. Inside this div, I want to render the content. So since it is C sharp part, what I have to say? Render body, right? So let us refresh it. Okay, again I am pressing F11. View start file is executing where layout property is set. Then after index view is executing where the layout property get altered. Now my layout get executed. Okay. So I hope you understand this, how to override the layout property. Now one more interesting thing. Now let me comment this part. Okay. We'll keep a normal layout page as a layout view. Okay. Underscore layout view. Here, if you are observing in code block, there is something written. View bag dot title is equal to index, right? So when title key is created, okay, and its value is assigned as index. Now where this view bag dot title is used, actually it is used in our layout page where the value of title is read and it is assigned to our title tag. Okay, means we'll again refresh our page. Let me remove this debug point. Okay, now let me refresh our page. See, this title get appeared here, index. Okay, this title is appearing here. Let me change it. Let us say home. Now let us refresh it. So here also home appears. So what you understand from this? Okay. So whatever you want to transfer from your view to parent view or layout view, what is used? View bag is used. And alternatively, definitely you can use view data also. So if you do not remember, those who don't know what is view bag or view data, please watch the video of state management. And in that video, I explain that view bag and view data are used to transfer information from controller to view as well as to its parent view. Okay. So I hope you enjoy this part. Please do the practice, then only it will be easy for you. Thank you.